A lot of the rubbish we throw away causes unnecessary pollution. Perhaps because it shouldn't be in the rubbish bin at all, or if it has to be there, maybe we should be saving it so that it can be used again. Let's look at the sort of rubbish that you'd find in any family dustbin. What have we, what have we got in here? We've got a big plastic bag, and it's got lettuce, potato peelings, eggs, all sorts of revolting things. Things that you reckon really are finished with. But you know, all this could be turned into compost. And compost can be spread on the land, and it helps to produce more food. Or it could be burned in power stations to make electricity. And this bottle, well, whatever was in this bottle has obviously been drunk, and you'd think now that that was rubbish. But this bottle could be melted down and used again. What else have we got in here? It's all rather smelly and revolting. I'll dig a bit deeper. Ah, I found a rather nasty milk bottle top, all sour milk. This milk bottle top is made of aluminium. Well, aluminium is a metal. It's the sort of thing that cooking pots and pans are made of, but of course there the aluminium is much thicker than this. And here's some more aluminium. Quite a lot of aluminium is actually used in the kitchen. This sort of thing here, which probably had an old meat pie in it. But all that can be melted down and used again. What else have we got? Well, we've got empty packets, paper, more empty packets, more empty packets. It's quite amazing just how much paper we go through. And something interesting about all the rubbish in this bin is that it was all used to contain, like this, or to wrap something you either wanted to eat or to keep. It's quite astonishing just how much packaging many of the things we buy include. Take this box of chocolates, for example. Now, when you buy a box of chocolates, the assistant puts it in a paper bag for you. And then round the chocolates, there's more paper. I'll rip all that off. And then underneath this paper, you've got the box itself. So we open that. And what have you got inside? More paper. And under that, yet more paper. And now we've got the chocolates. And they're in more paper. Underneath that, another row of more paper. And then another row of chocolates in more paper. It seems to me that there's an awful lot of paper for just a few chocolates. And you know, it's the same with a lot of things that we buy. All these things, for example. I mean, look at this box. Again, it seems to me that there's rather a lot of packaging for just what's inside. And you know, packaging costs a lot too. Sometimes the packaging costs as much or even more than what's inside. And paper and cardboard are very expensive because they're made from wood. And wood is very scarce too. But you know, if all this paper could somehow be taken to a factory, most of it could be used again. And that's what we call recycling.